Hello, everybody. Lost, guys. We're back in an episode of Ultra Mammal Dreadnoughts. We are invading Russia pretty hard. We're about to finish with our naval invasions and ensue for peace, and then either fight the French or fight the Chinese. I love how they're starting their land invasion of Ukraine when the naval invasion's almost done. Oh, Consta. It was like Constantinople. No, it's the Romanian port where there are a bunch of ships repairing. Now I'll put that priority for looking for stuff that has oil. After this next naval line, I want to see what that is. We'll send that fleet back home to repair. I'm going to try to negotiate peace with Russia. This war is over. We've gotten the Black Sea objectives. I may or may not have a trapped Black Sea fleet that is going to be slowly disbanded due to stupid Turks. I think they let me in, and now they're refusing to let me back out. I think that's why I couldn't go all the way back. I'm trying to get into the Aegean Sea to see if that will let me out. Okay, I'm gonna pause the video until it finally builds the stupid ships. Jeez. Finally, it finished after like a minute. Failed negotiations. You know what? I think I can actually fight this. As long as we keep our distance. Because this is a fast cruiser. This is a fast battleship. This isn't a slow battle. I can actually maneuver this thing. Now, defending the convoy might be a pipe dream. I might just be focusing on killing the enemy fleet. Even if they kill all the transports, losing the entire attacking force would be devastating to the French. Because trade ship is not worth warship. No, this is the old battleship, so it is going to have maneuverability problems. I don't care if we lose all of our speed, just turn. This is why you leave at least 1 inch of armor across the ship. You can't get memed by a 2-inch gun. I kind of love just blocking that 8-inch shell. And ricocheting it. I think they're low on fuel. That's why they're going so slow. Thank you. Ooh, there we go. Finally got caused the flooding. I'll finally start slowing it down. So I got that, finally got that 1,500 range found, meaning the gunner knows exactly how far it is and how to hit it. Thank you. the battleship's not even considered medium health. It's still considered light damage. I'm happy that I put torpedo protection on that, because that probably saved me from a lot of damage. No. You literally just lost the first battle. You're like, nah, I'm good. Hey, Russia. I'm done. Sign a peace treaty. You're done, son. Is this the newer battleship? No, it's the Vita. It's the VI class. Meaning it's most likely the old battleship. No, it's the new one. I'm a derp. With its 8 million guns. The thing is, this thing also moves like a battlecruiser, and or it moves a lot faster than a lot of other, than most would think. Although it does have 7 funnels. Love how fast this thing can go backwards. On a dime, due to its engine efficiency. This is a lesson that, don't take all of ships, like, that is their capabilities, because these guys had better torps than the other ships that I was facing. That was, like, point-blank range of them. Their torps work, best at, 3 kilometers. I'd rather take the end battle with this ship almost destroyed than losing the battleship. That might seem a little bit cheesy, but due to how inflexible the battle system is, theoretically we could say that it's reinforcing ships arriving on my side that can force them back. There is other battleships in the area. It's not impossible for that to happen. That's why there's an in-battle button. Is it literally because there's a Russian ship blocking the way? Is that what's happening here? No, it might actually be it, because it has a naval control zone that blocks the entire array. Yeah, I kind of want to white piece the Chinese right now to get my forces out of China so it stops helping the Germans and the Germans start losing China. But that'll be it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, please have a like, comment, subscribe, and peace!